Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to do three finger treats that are sweet. And the first one is with regard to a request that I had. I think one of my little decorations on a plate one night was frosted grapes. And so someone asked me to go ahead and demonstrate how to make frosted grapes. So we'll start right there. What I have is one egg white in this bowl that I've been whisking around, and I need to add just a splash of lemon juice. I just used it out of a bottle. It doesn't have to be fresh lemon juice, but fresh lemon juice would be fine. Just a little bit, not too much. And what you want to do is to get this egg white, which is just a single egg white, to the point where it's frothy. So it's not giving peaks. It's not to that point. It doesn't need to be. So it's fine the way it is. Now the grapes have been prepared a little bit ahead of time. I had some red seedless grapes. These are medium sized, and I stuck them in the freezer about 4 hours ago. You can work with them from 3 hours up to a whole week of having them in the freezer, but they are easier to work with if you freeze them. I'm also going to prepare this bag, which is just a Ziploc bag that will have 1 cup of granulated sugar, just regular sugar. So that will be for the frosting. So what we do is get this whisk to the point that it looks nice and not separated or anything. And then we can put all of our grapes in, since these aren't too many. Actually, I counted these out so you would know there are 40 medium sized. If you have really large sized ones, then 20 for this amount. If you want to do a cluster, then you can do a cluster that would be equivalent to about that many grapes. So we're going to put that in to our mixture, and I think it would be nice now if I had a spoon to stir that up. Get all those coated nicely. And then what I'm going to do next, see how they look? I'm going to place them in a colander and let any of the excess egg white go through that colander. You can use a strainer, and you can see that there's not going to be a lot that goes through. And that's why I have these paper towels right here. The next thing to do is to put these out on a paper towel. Actually, I didn't get much through at all. Just, you can probably see on the bottom there, there's some oozings of the egg white, but not much. So here's where the getting rid of the extra liquid comes in. You need some paper towels ready, because you're not going to get rid of a lot of it that way. You don't want to eliminate everything that you've put on it. You want them sticky. You just don't want them overly so, because that means they will be too liquidy and the sugar will not stick in the way you want it to. So just move them around a little bit, getting some of that egg white off. Not all of it, but some of it will be taken off. And then when you're satisfied with that, and this looks okay, you're going to drop a few at a time into your bag and shake it. And you can see why the sugar is going to stick to them, because we have something that is fairly sticky right there. So shake them and then bring them out and put them on a plate. Try not to bring out too much sugar with them. And you see how nice those look as frosted grapes? And we'll go ahead and try to quickly do a few more of these. You can use these as decor, but they are edible. And I would like to say that the latest view on raw egg whites is that it's perfectly safe if it has come from an egg whose shell has not been cracked or broken. And also the egg white has not been mixed with the egg yolk. So you don't need to worry about the safety of eating these. After I get these on this plate, what I'm going to do is just let them dry, because that's the form that they generally are going to look the nicest, when you have these nice grapes that are coated with sugar and that egg white has dried on it, then they are all set. After that, I would place them in the refrigerator. So I hope this answered your question. Now, I know I did have a clump of grapes, but I thought, let's just do something a little different so that you'll see the clump, and decide to do it either that way, and you'll also see the individual grapes and about how many you use in what proportion. So you can just put them at the edge of some serving plate if you want to, and then put whatever, which could be fruit or vegetable or entree, anything that you like to put with your frosted grapes. Now, I think I told you at the beginning we were going to have three things, so let's move on to our next sweet treat. Get rid of some of this stuff. I'm washing my hands because they're very sugary right now. And I have a towel over here. And let's clean this up just a bit. Okay, we can work with that, I think. And I'll put this over here. What I have here are two little sweet treats that you might want to have on hand at any time. I want to show you how easy these are. These are bananas, which are banana slices, which have been dipped in melted chocolate. So over here you have your double boiler, and I would turn it on, except I'm not going to go through that process. I've done that many times in many of my recipes. But you melt your chocolate, it could be semi-sweet or milk chocolate. You dip your slice of banana in it and then place it over here on wax paper. And when it sets up, which you may freeze it if you want to, I did freeze these, then it's ready to serve. After they're frozen, you can serve them frozen, or you can thaw them out and serve them that way. What I have here are some vanilla wafers. I usually get the reduced fat kind, these aren't. And I'm going to spread them with some strawberry flavored cream cheese. And all of them are spread except this last one, just to show you. It's very easy. It's the quickest appetizer, sweet appetizer, that you can possibly get, and it's great. So I hope you enjoy the banana slices dipped in chocolate, the vanilla wafers with the cream cheese strawberry topping, and also the frosted grapes.